In this section, we're going to take a look at the navigation. Now, the navigation is another cool thing because you get to change the menu structure here and you get to do some really cool things with it. And I want you to definitely explore it. Once again, I always tell people this, when you are working on a brand new framework like this, you can't damage it. So feel free to click around. Before you start creating your content, feel free to explore, click around, change things, edit things. If you make a mistake, you just, you know, reload it again and you're good to go. So let's edit this here. Let's click on the edit. We're going to activate it. So when you look at the very top here, it's asking you to select the main menu that you want to be at the top. Right now it's set to the default. So let's go back to the Joomla menu system. When I click on this drop down here, you can assign any one of these menus to be the primary menu on your front end, which is right here. So let's go back to the home. So any one of the menus you see back here can be assigned to any one of these, to this section here. So to demonstrate that, let me say I didn't want the main menu to be the menu that shows up here. Well, I can just click here to change it. And when I do that, it refreshes. Then it gives the menu here. So right now we're going to the Joomla brands. Let's go to the back end. Let's go to the brands. So this same menu that you're seeing here is the same menu that you see here, is the same menu that you see on the front end. Let's refresh the front end. Now the reason why the front end, when you refresh it, didn't change is because you have to first click on save. What this does is this here, you send this in real time. So even though you've seen this in real time and you don't see it on the front end yet, you have to first click on save in order to activate it. So let's do that. Let's click on save. So when you refresh it now, you notice that it's showing the menus that you've selected on the back end. So you always want to make sure if you want to see something on the front end, you first have to click on save and you have to reactivate it again. And with each one, you can add additional classes. You can add icon. You can add captions. And I want you to experiment with this. The icons, they're using the Font Awesome icons that you can be able to add. You can go to fontawesome.com to see all the different icons and how to add those. So that's another homework for you to do. And you can go to each one. And the beautiful thing about each one is you can create a mega menu for each item. So let's say I wanted to build a mega menu of this Joomla right here. So I'm going to click on this. Now I've activated the mega menu, and then you have this width right here, the 300 pixels. You can change this. You can expand it. You can decrease it. And what this means is the width, when I put my mouse around, if you can see that, when I put it here, you see that drop little slightly drop down because there's nothing there. Well, you're going to see something in a minute. Now they have extra classes you can be able to add here for CSS, but I don't want to cover that. So you can choose the alignment. You can choose this alignment, however you want this particular menu to be aligned. And when you come to the bottom here, you notice that you can move it. So you can add multiple things here. You can move one up top. It's very simple. You can delete it. Yes. You can also go to this here to add more. You can add more column that way. So I'm going to close that out. So now let's take a look at adding an item in this menu. Now you can add an item on the back end here, or you can do the same thing by going to click on the item, and then you can add sub menus, you can add pictures, you can add a bunch of different things. But let's go back here to the back end so you can see. So from this now it says none because you don't have anything there. So just click on this. When you do, you can add a title for it, but I'm not gonna, you know, add a title. You can, if you want to, you can put in a new menu just for the back end. This is not going to show on the front end. And you can select an option. Do you want this content to pull from a module position, from a module, or from a menu item? So based on what you select here, you can be able to pull that. So let's click on this module position. It's going to ask you to select module position. So you have to choose the module positions that you want. So all of these should have different items on them. All these are module positions. You can choose any one of these to go on there, or you can also choose, you go back, you can choose a module. This means that you choose a specific module that already has the content. You can use that to put there as well. And all the modules, let's go back to the extensions and go to modules. Now, this is all the modules that are on the site, and each one have an item with it. So let's click, let's say, for the logo. This is one that I have on here that you can be able to see that it looks blank. I think it's probably because something is actually there. We go to tools, you go to source. Now, when you look at the source, this is the logo that's shown there, but you can't see it because the background, it blends with the background. So I'm going to click cancel, but I just wanted you to see that there is something there. You can't really see that, so you have to go look through the source code. So I'm going to close that off. So back here, you can choose a module. You choose any one of these off canvas, or you can choose, this is just the module style. And so this one here, the top one is fine. You can experiment with these here as well. Or you can choose a menu item. So that's there's no menu items here. You can add one. So when you go to module, so feel free, by the way, feel free to click in anything and see how it looks. So I'm gonna click on border styles. I'm not even sure what's in that module, so we'll see. So now you can see this is what in that particular module called border styles. It's the new menu. And I can change it to something else, connect with us for the logo, whatever I want to change it to. I just want you to be able to see that you can make that change with that there. You can also add an additional row. In the additional row, you can come in and you can choose another module. Let's see what module we want to choose. We can choose connect with us. Again, I'm not sure what's in that module, but we're going to see. So click apply. And when you put it down, now you have this connect with us at the bottom. So I just wanted you to see that the modules, the menu system here is really powerful. It has a lot of things you can add to it. You can have the animation. Do you want it to slide? Do you want it to fade? That's how the menu is going to show. So when you put your mouse on it, it kind of slowly just fades in. That's where this happens, zoom. So have fun choosing one of these. The duration is just in seconds, how fast it shows. And then next you have the off canvas. Now the off canvas, this is the menu that you see when you are browsing on your phone or sometimes on your tablet. At all, you can show it on the right side or you can show it on desktop. So when I activated this on desktop, you notice you have this right here. So when you click on it, it's going to show this menu right over here. You can also show it on the right side as well. So you can activate these here. And this is where you have some fun with it. You can choose what item to go in that particular position. You can choose the style. They have different styles you can choose from. Experiment with those and see which ones that you like. And then you can choose the effect. Do you want it to slide along, reverse slide out, 3D rotate? So feel free to really just have fun with this thing. You know, this is where the fun part comes in. And then you have the menu breakpoint, which kind of breaks the menu up into sections. So you have the LG screen, the small, the large, and the medium. So once you make the changes that you're satisfied with, you can just click on save. And then if you ever need to modify anything again, you can always do that. So now the changes that you've made, let's go to the front end. We'll refresh it, it's going to show. So now we have the front end menus. As you can see, what you added, nice, clean, and very easy to access.